questions usually got the answers that I need. Intuition telling me, I just have a good feeling.
What's up, everybody? It has been a minute, but I am so glad to see you guys' beautiful faces and talk to you all once again. April has been a long month. It's been a long time since I met you. Something, something, something. Step two. Y'all, it's been a long time since I've been talking to y'all. I didn't want to come to y'all in that mental space that I was in. Like, April was kind of rough for me, all right? Mentally. But I didn't want to come to y'all in that mental space that I was in. I want to come to y'all as clear and level-headed as possible. So like I said, I'm back and I'm better, okay? And we're back for a while, okay? The semester's coming to a close. I've been stressed out about that and other things. But before I talk about the other things, I want to give you the title of today's video. Today's video is titled, Be Careful What You Ask For. So this topic literally popped in my head last night, and that's how I knew I was coming back to myself, because no topics were coming in my head to talk about to y'all. And that's how I knew I won't write, you know what I'm saying? Because I always got something to say. But last night, it dawned on me that I had said something last summer, the summer of the pandemic, yes, last summer. And what I had said to my best friend, what I said to her was, I want to experience heartbreak before I get into marriage. You know, I never experienced that first heartbreak thing. But baby, I think I just did. Okay, so y'all, it was not good. But yes, I literally put that out into the air. Now, what sane person wants to experience heartbreak? Okay, but hear my reasoning. So I want to experience heartbreak before I hit marriage. Like, I didn't want to go into marriage like thinking that everything was going to be great, you know what I'm saying? I just wanted to know how my emotions run and roam and rampage, just in case I got hurt or my feelings got hurt, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, I want to experience my first heartbreak. Like, I don't want to be 30 and getting my heart broken then. Like, no, I wanted to see all of them, my emotions and what they could come to and whatnot. Okay, that's my reasoning. It don't make much sense, but it make a little bit of sense. Okay, so I'm not gonna tell all my business up here, but let's just say I experienced heartbreak on different levels. Just like most of you all, y'all have probably lost a friend in your lifetime. And yeah, that hurts, because especially if like you were genuine the whole time, it hurts when you lose a friend. You know what I'm saying? But have y'all ever lost a friend and a person you liked at the same time? That's two birds and one stone, y'all. Like, So it's always a risk of losing a friend when feelings get involved. All right. But when I asked God, or I don't know if I specifically asked God, but I know that I spoke it out into the air. And this is why I encourage speaking life. That was not really speaking life when I said I wanted to experience heartbreak. That was not life at all, okay? That really was actually like death. Okay, anyway. So when I said that I wanted to experience heartbreak, I wasn't expecting it to come from this person. Like, this was a person that I thought cared about me. I thought he protected me. Okay, let me go back. He did protect me until recently. Like, it's so crazy because I can laugh at it now, but earlier this month, your girl was down bad. Like, I cannot express how bad I was. Like, I'm a genuinely bubbly person, I believe. I've been told I'm not, but I think I'm pretty bubbly, you know what I'm saying? But I do have a guard up, and I just don't like getting hurt. But the one time I let my guard down and be vulnerable, I did. And it was by a person that I least expected it. So it kind of hurt my little heart in different ways. But I just want to say I'm back and I'm better. This video was not meant to be long, but I'm just letting you know that God is listening to what you're saying, okay? So I'm encouraging you all to speak life over yourself. don't say anything that you don't truly want to happen. Like I said, I wanted to experience heartbreak. I won't expect an experience heartbreak from something that I won't even end a darn relationship for. Like literally, y'all, I went through spurts of depression. I lost weight this month alone. I didn't want to talk to anybody. I had no appetite. I just wanted to be to myself. Then I went through spurts of crazy. Like I literally felt like I could have been in a Tyler Perry movie, like playing some crazy black woman. Like it was so many different sides of emotions that came out of me that I didn't even know I had. So I'm just encouraging you all to be careful of what you put out into the air, because God or something, whatever you believe in, is listening, okay? And when you put it out there, just know it's a chance it's gonna come back to you, okay? So from now on, I'm speaking only life, and I think that's gonna be my next, never mind, I'm not gonna tell, but I'm only speaking life, okay? And I encourage you all to do the same. Don't speak nothing over your life that you don't want to happen. I did not expect it to be like this, y'all. I did not expect it to be like this, but I'm kind of glad that it happened. I had to remind myself that everything happens for a reason. And the feelings with a friendship kind of don't encourage that. It's just a chance that you're gonna lose a friend, or if they were a friend the whole time. Anyway, that's just another story for another day, all right? But yeah, I was not expecting it to come from this situation. And most of the time you would think heartbreak comes from an actual relationship. Don't deal with situationships, y'all. Know your worth out here, okay? Know your worth, okay? Like, get it together. Like I said, I'm back and I'm better now. I'm getting better every day. I'm getting my peace with the situation and everything that's happened. But like I said, be careful what you put out into the air. Be careful what you ask for. Be careful what you say, because chances are it's gonna come back and make it happen, okay? So with that being said, I'm about to manifest stuff into my life and yours, all right? So, manifesting is praying for me. All right, you can call it what you want, but you can't call me broke. Anyway, like manifesting is praying. So like I said, I spoke that out into the air last summer. Let's speak a relationship over my life that's gonna make me happy. All right, because the male species, y'all, the male species, that's all I'm gonna say. I can't say it's not some girls out here that are trifling, but my little heart can't take it. It cannot take it, y'all. Like, I wear my heart on my sleeve, and my cousin was like, I'm proud of you for being vulnerable in this situation. Because I'm not vulnerable with my emotions and my feelings. And this is the reason why. But like I said, we're going to manifest a happy, great relationship with a dude, a faithful black king who knows what he wants, doesn't lead you on, who is just as sure as he can be that he want to be with you and not wasting your time or nobody else's time or straggling you along, playing with your emotions and in your face, point blank period. We're praying for all of that in my lives and in yours, if that's what you want. Pray for what you want of your life, but do not speak anything negative out into the air, because it's a chance it's gonna come back. This video is not meant to be long at all. It's a little mini rant, mini story time. I didn't go into detail, but you can kind of read between the lines, all right? I'm not trying to open that wound back up. But yes, if you would, if you could, if you would please like this video down below, comment down below, subscribe if you're not a subscriber, turn your notification bell on. I'm going to be back with more content sooner rather than later. I told y'all I'm back. I took a month break because I want me, but I'm back and I'm better, and I took some lessons out of this ill, okay? But yes, I love y'all. Thank y'all for watching this video. We're still in the middle of a pandemic. I encourage everybody to get vaccinated. Might as well go ahead and do it. Let's get back to normal. And still wear your mask out here. Drink your water. Do all of that good stuff. Wear your deodorant. Some of y'all are smelling wrong. It's starting to get hot outside. Wear your deodorant, y'all. I'm just talking now. I missed y'all. But yes, thank you for watching another video of NGBTV. And just speak life over yourself. And don't say nothing that you don't want to happen, because it's a chance it will. All right, y'all. Bye.